In this video, we're going to continue our exploration of compositing by taking a look at Primatte Studio inside of BorisFX Continuum for keying out green or blue from a shot, otherwise known as a green screen or a blue screen. The magical part about this effect is that it allows you to keep on the fine details of your foreground subject while easily removing unwanted material. So I'm going to hop in here into my 5B sequence. And I'm monitoring the V2 track where I have my subject on a green screen background that happens to be uneven. We also have a lot of undesirable junk on the edges of the frame, not even green. Just below the track on V2 is our background plate, which we'd like to blend in our foreground subject here. Before applying Primatte Studio, you do want to make sure in the timeline your video quality is set to full. This will give you an accurate reflection of detail when we zoom in. And we want to go here to BCC Primatte Studio in the key and blend category, which will apply to the clip on the V2 track. Let's enter into effect mode and notice something in our record monitor. It's a UI specifically designed for this effect. Now, one of the great things about Primatte is its ability to auto-analyze your clip and just take a guess at trying to remove as much green as possible. For that, we're going to use the auto-analyze button. If we click on this, you can see that it has removed the majority of the green. And if we play it back, it's done a fairly good job at preserving most of the subject. You might see some chewy details here seeping through from the original green. Not to mention we have the edges to worry about, but we'll get to that in a little bit. So to see this a bit clearer, I'm going to zoom in, enlarge my shot, and then press Command Option to pan. And we're going to hop into another view. Let's start off by looking at matte status. And what this information is conveying is white is what we want to keep, our foreground subject. Black is what we want to remove, our entire green screen, and gray represents something that's semi-transparent. It's not opaque and it's not transparent, it's somewhere in between. We do have a lot of these details here in the green screen. I'm less concerned about it here in the garbage areas because we'll use another tool to get rid of that. But to clean this up, all we have to do is focus on making sure this is set to clean background. So we've auto-analyzed. This is set to clean background, and we can use one of two tools in order to try to clean this up, a point or rectangular-based selection. I'll choose rectangle. I'm going to click and drag over that gray area to draw a marquee, and we can see that that gray section has now been cleaned up. I'll continue to do it over some of these areas here, but while paying attention to my subject, because I don't want to remove that selection. I'll also zoom out just to do this here towards the bottom of the floor. And by any reason, if you go too far when trying to remove some of these gray areas, keep in mind that you can edit and undo your last step here from the menu. So I'll select that again with the rectangular marquee tool. Let's hop over to final matte. It's going to be a better reflection of how this is going to look on final output. And I'll play this back to see that there are some detail here in our foreground subject that we want to bring back in, especially around her right hand here. I'm going to click on the clean foreground button in order to fix this. And we'll use a point-based selection. Click over those areas that had those holes. And same thing here at the bottom. And once again, you could start to see that we're bringing in just little bits of detail back into our hair. We should also look at this in final composite mode, keeping in mind that I am zoomed in quite a bit, so I'll just zoom out one level to make sure that we have most of that detail. In the areas where we might be losing some of that detail, click to drag to restore some of that. Now, in addition to the restore detail option, I did want to take a close look at the colors that are currently around the hair. You can see that the green screen is reflecting on our edges, which is something that's undesirable. What you should note is if we take a close look at the spill category, you'll just want to twirl down these properties, that a level of spill suppression has already been applied. It's currently set to complement, which basically adds the opposite color of green, magenta in this case, and tries to fix the edges around your subject or any area where green is being reflected on your subject. If I bring down this spill replace amount all the way down to zero, we see more green here on those edges. In addition to complement, there is another spill replace mode that can be very handy. We can use soften background, which will take into consideration whatever is set to your background layer. And by default, that's the first track below. And now when we bring up that spill replace amount, instead of magenta, it's bringing in parts of the background. Now where Primatte Studio really shines is in your ability to combine your first level of spill suppression with a secondary spill suppression. And all we have to do is turn on the secondary spill remover, which is just underneath those spill properties we've been playing with. And look at what a great job it does fixing up the remaining green spill. Now we can bring down our first spill replace amount with the softened background, but also play around with the bias amount for how much magenta, if we are not getting the desired results, so either too much green or too much of the opposite color being reintroduced in our clip. And using a combination of this secondary spill remover with our primary spill gives us the ideal end result for those edges on our subject. And yes, we still have our edges to deal with. For this, we can rely on some controls under outside mask. And to access this, and just underneath our spill values is the outside mask options. One of those is to go inside of Mocha and create our own custom masks that we can use to hide parts of the edges of our frame. But there's also a handy crop tool, which gives us UI controls right here in the record monitor. If I drag the top left one in, I remove the edge on the left-hand side. And if I drag the one on the bottom right end, I do the same. And now we don't have to worry about any of that garbage on those edges seeping through into our composite. I'll just hop over to final mats so we can see that we might want to still remove some of those edges here on our right-hand side. Go back to final composite and start to play a little bit more with the detail around the edges of our subject. In general, in addition to the spill suppression, we do want to have some of the light from the background wrap around the edges of our subject. Now, there just so happens to be a view called light wrap on black, and currently we won't see anything on our record monitor when we hop into it until we enable light wrap edge on. All of a sudden, referencing that background layer, we can see the light wrapping around the edges of our subject. To control this, if we go into the light wrap edge properties, in this case, I'm going to bring down the width a bit to 2, increase the softness. We could also play around with the lightness of this as well. After we've made adjustments in this view, it's best to hop to final composite and just disable and enable light wrap to see the effects it has on the fine detail, not to mention the edges. I'll bring the softness down in this case so we don't remove too much of that hair detail by turning on light wrap. We can also perform some color correction on our foreground plate so that the colors of this subject represent a bit more of the environment that she's in. So hopping into color correction, I'll go to the color temperature and slide this up a bit to introduce more warmer tones. Bring down a bit of the saturation and play with the other values to taste. Once we've done all of these adjustments, because of BorisFX's geometrics that are built into several effects, we can scale and reposition our main subject. I'll twirl up the color correction section. Let's head into geometrics. It's enabled, and I'll just bring down the scale of my main subject. If you bring it down too much, you'll start to see the outside frame that we cropped off, we can always just adjust our upper left and lower right crop to taste if required. When we make those adjustments, I'll settle on a scale value of 96 and then reposition the Y point a bit more and noting the order of operations. So I'll head to the top of the effect and just bypass it temporarily so we could see, remove the garbage on the outside of the mask, as well as play it around with geometrics and adjusting spill suppression and light wrap in order to integrate our subject into this green screen shot. For more information on the other tools that are built inside of Primatte Studio, don't forget to check out a variety of videos that are available on BorisFX.com.